Welcome back, guys. Another day in the shop. This is Grant with Freedom Van Gogh here in Jacksonville, Florida. So today we are going to install Flarespace flares. It's kind of one of the biggest modifications you're going to do to your van, mainly because of the expense, the time, and the addition of space for you. We like to do the flares because it basically saves you almost 2 feet into the van, especially on a 144 like you see behind me. It helps a lot. So you can have the width of a queen, which is like 60 inches, versus the length of a queen, which is around 79. We go into 76 because we can tuck him into the rear door a little bit. So you save quite a bit of livable space inside the van. So for us, it's a no-brainer. We prefer to build 144s versus 170s, and we find, you know, the daily drivability makes it worth it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through the process of installing the flares and show you guys how we do it. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna cut out where the factory windows would normally be. We're gonna scuff up the area around where the sealant's gonna be at. We're gonna clean it real good so that we get good adhesion, and then we'll bond the flares on from there. This is gonna kind of be a start to finish. The only thing that we don't physically do is we have a local upholstery place line the flares with a diamond stitch fabric. Let's get to work. All right, so there's about 15,000 different ways to do this. The way I like to do it is I come with a basically quarter inch drill bit and drill a little off the edge of the whole window area. And then I come on with a step bit and open it up a little bit. I like to cut from the outside because it's faster. And when you cut from the inside, you tend to nick the actual window surround. I find if I drill basically a bunch of holes, which make a template from the outside that you can trace and then line up, then it makes it way faster and easier to do it more accurately. So on the back of your van, just like on the front, on the slider and the crew side window, there's a lip that's already here. So we're gonna be cutting along the inside of this lip, just like if you were gonna have a factory window. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a whole bunch of little holes all around so that we can know where we're drilling to, and we'll go from there. So got all the holes drilled out. So as you can see, we went big in the corners. And the reason for that is because it makes it easier to round that corner. And then we went small along here. And that's so we can line up a straight edge so that we can mark the line down to the corners. So in reality, this doesn't actually have to be 100% perfect. The flare ends up about here in the front and all the way here in the back. So for all intents and purposes, this doesn't have to be like super perfect. I'm kind of anal retentive, but you're not gonna see any of this once the flares go on, once your trim rings go on, all that stuff. So if you're not super perfect with everything, it's not gonna make or break anything. Let's go ahead and cut it out. So now you got your hole cut out, you gotta dress up the edges, and then we'll paint all the edges and wait for it to dry and then install it later. Flapper wheel, a sanding wheel, on an angle grinder is pretty much the same thing. It's just a whole bunch of sandpaper. You don't want to use an actual grinding wheel because it creates too much heat, and heat is the enemy of primer and paint, and you'll actually damage the bond between the paint and the thing. That's why I don't tell anybody to use an angle grinder and cut off wheel to cut this off. That's why you always use a reciprocating saw of some sort in order to cut it. It's less heat generated. So we'll go over things like these little steps here. Like, I like everything to be nice and smooth. It helps, especially if you're going to trim this out on the inside with just foam and fabric and not actually do a wall. This step right here makes a huge difference. So there's little undulations like here where you kind of start and stop, and here in the corner and just a little bit here. We're just gonna smooth everything out and make it all nice and even and pretty, and then go from there. And that's pretty much it. I'm pretty happy with all the corners and all that stuff. So when you go to wrap it, everything will flow really well. So now what we're gonna do is wipe it all down with alcohol and then paint all the bare edges with a paint. We tend to use Rust-Oleum. It lasts really long and it's nice and thick. If you notice, we taped everything kind of to the sides and on the bottom. And the main reason why is when you get all these hot shards as you're drilling and cutting falling on here, you'll actually start to develop rust spots where the metal has melted into the clear coat. You can see here, if you look in the magnet, how much you actually collect. It's a whole lot of metal. So make sure you kind of try and protect anything that can catch any metal. It'll make your life a lot easier in the end. You won't have to worry about cleaning it and clear cutting, buffing it and stuff like that. So yeah, let's go ahead and finish her up and call it a day. We're just finishing up painting all the exposed surfaces. It seems tedious, and I've seen some guys like just slather stuff on there, but for me, this is a little relaxing. Kind of enjoy it. And you definitely want to make sure that when you're done with all this, that you go ahead and wipe everything down on the inside, because you're going to have a lot of metal shavings and flakes and stuff like that. So you want to make sure that you clean everything up so you don't create any rust issues further down the road. That's why you see I taped up these holes under the window. So we showed you guys how to cut out the panels, how to figure out where you're cutting at, all that jazz. So what we're gonna do now is we're going to prep the flare to go ahead and put the flares on. For this process, it's pretty easy. All you really need is rubber gloves. We do double gloves. That way, if you get one really nasty, it's easy to pop it off and you still have a rubber glove on. Some Scotch-Brite, some acetone to clean the flare area. This is the included 3M550FC 1-inch wide tape. We fillet all the edges and fill the gaps instead of just a little bead. I find that it continues the OEM seam lines a little bit better and looks a little nicer, so we're gonna do that. Caulking gun, a decent gun is nice. And paper towels. It's not good to like keep folding and keep using paper towels. I tend to make a bunch of little squares. And this allows you to have basically an unlimited source of paper towels that you can just use and then throw on the ground and then clean up when you're done. This makes it a lot faster because this stuff sets up really quick and you want to make sure you can clean it up as soon as possible. We use mineral spirits to clean it up because it doesn't harm the paint, and the 3M stuff seems to respond very well to it. So this step really isn't super required, but the reason I do it is to knock off any imperfections, anything that's stuck to it during shipping. We're just gonna use some Scotch-Brite on the flange area. We're just gonna clean the surface so that you get good adhesion. All right, so at this point, we're gonna go ahead and apply the adhesive. I put it on kind of thick because I don't want leaks. We always want to make sure we cake it on, because you can always wipe it off, but you can't put extra on once the flare is on the van. So So the bottom side isn't as important as making sure this entire top side's really good, because a lot of this is just gonna drip down, and you'll also fill it from the inside as well easier than you'll be able to the fronts and the back. So still important to get good coverage, but I always go thicker on the top and the corners. So I put it a little thicker in the very back here. And the reason for that is because when you push it on, I want it to ooze out to the sides so that it helps to fill the gap on the back of the van that you'll see us smooth out later. Let it sit for just a second and set up so that it doesn't slide around as much when you put it on the van. And this is something that you don't really have to do, but I do it so that it saves time when cleaning the adhesive up. So you see that's a really nice roll formed edge. That's what we call a fillet. That gives it a really nice look. So shortly after you lay the adhesive down, it's gotta be pretty much set. You see me breaking some of these tapes to do some of this. And that's really because it's not that big of a deal, because it'll hold itself in place. And then I'm going to put new pieces up. But you definitely want to get all your edges off, so they're nice and clean. And you see this nice little fillet here gives it a really good appearance all the way around. All right, so this flare is now installed. It's been wiped down, clean. We just got to do a final clean on it and make it all pretty once it's dry. But as you can see, it's got a nice even fillet all around it. Super easy, you can do it in your driveway. Like, it's really not that hard. The Flarespace Flares lets you sleep sideways. It gives you a queen size bed. You save, again, roughly like a foot and a half worth of space on your interior. So it's better for your build out, especially if you have 144. If you have any questions, let us know, but give it a try, tackle it. You can do it, it just takes time. Just be patient, be methodical, take your time, do it right. Just get out and enjoy a van. Live life without limits.